Hi, I'm Max Arco, and welcome to Season 3 of Architecture All Access. As you may know, Architecture All Access is a masterclass technology series featuring senior Intel technical leaders taking an educational approach in explaining the historical impact and future innovations in their technical domains. Over the past two seasons, we have covered topics like CPU and FPGA architectures, quantum and neuromorphic computing, transistor technology, artificial intelligence, and much, much more. If you haven't watched those seasons, a link to those playlists is in the description below. We are so grateful for all the great feedback from the community, seeing your eagerness to learn, your curiosity and engagement with this technology content, and we truly appreciate your thoughtful comments. For Season 3, we decided to cover the different technologies and architectures inside our upcoming Meteor Lake family of processors. Expect a behind-the-scenes, all-access view of the considerations our architects and designers went through, as well as an architectural view of the final design decisions we made. As with prior seasons, do let us know what you think of this approach and comment on what future topics you want us to cover. Before we jump into our first episode and delve into an architectural overview of Meteor Lake, let's talk high level. What is Meteor Lake? And what are some of the key technologies inside the product? Meteor Lake is our next generation tile-based architecture built from four disaggregated tiles, connected via our industry-leading Foveros 3D packaging technology on the all-new Intel 4 process technology. The pillars upon which we designed Meteor Lake were to build our most power-efficient client processor yet, bring AI at scale to the PC, and deliver a leaping graphics performance with increased power efficiency. As a result, our architects and design engineers were pushed to break away from the status quo and rethink the entire chip architecture from the ground up. At the foundation of an efficient architecture lies the type and function of ingredients or IPs that you choose for your design, and efficiently connecting those together. While current architectures in our lineup are optimized for performance, with Meteor Lake, we changed our traditional partitioning habits, and we repartitioned the IPs to be truly optimized for power efficiency. In the first episode this season, Tim Wilson, Intel's VP of Design Engineering and General Manager for Client SoC Design, will take you through all considerations of IP repartitioning and disaggregation, as well as an overview of the Meteor Lake architecture. Beyond efficiently connecting and repartitioning IPs, we focus on selecting the right types of computer resources to process modern workloads. In Meteor Lake, we introduce a new level of hybrid, which we call 3D Performance Hybrid Architecture, reflecting the three types of CPU cores that we put into it and the strategic placement of those cores across different tiles for power efficiency. In episode 2, Rashi Shabuskar, Intel Fellow in the Client Computing Group, will talk all about the new 3D Performance Hybrid Architecture. She will also cover how we enhance our Intel Thread Director technology to schedule the right workloads on the right CPU cores for optimal performance and power efficiency. Gaming, creating, and streaming are fundamental to today's PC entertainment. That's why we've taken a bold step forward in graphics IP. We have taken our Intel Arc GPU architecture, which is optimized for high-performance graphics, and tuned it to fit in low-power envelopes. The result is an architecture optimized for performance per watt and a leap in graphics performance. We will talk more about how we achieve that in episode 3. With the growth in AI power experiences like generative AI, AI assistants, and AI-assisted collaboration and creation, the importance of efficiently handling those types of tasks and doing that in a local client is accelerating rapidly. To complement our existing CPU and GPU AI acceleration, we added a dedicated low-power AI engine called the NPU, or Neural Processing Unit, ideal for sustained AI and AI offload. We'll talk more about the whys and the hows of AI in Meteor Lake in our fourth episode. All these revolutionary changes in the architecture have led to this: a power-efficient, four-tile disaggregated architecture connected through our 3D Foveros packaging technology, assembling everything together with considerations for high bump density, low transfer energy, and low latency. We will dive into the details of this packaging technology in episode 5. We can't wait to share all these videos with you, so please be sure to subscribe to the channel to make sure you don't miss any of the episodes. Thank you for joining me today, and welcome to Architectural Access Season 3.